Hey everyone, Gary Simon of Corsetro. So today we're going to take a look at a design tool, and it works for multiple operating systems, and it's called Gravit Designer. It's free, and it's also something that you can use in a desktop app environment, but also on the web. And I'm a really big fan of the tools of it. There are some limitations, which we'll talk about, but let's go ahead and get started. But first, make sure you subscribe here and check out Corsetro.com. Okay, so first you go to Gravit.io, and this is where you can do one of two things. You can actually download a desktop app, and it works for multiple operating systems. Or you could use the online version. All right, so you click on this, and this will load up this page right here. And this is basically a replicate of the desktop app, which is right here. So you could see it looks almost exactly the same. And let me go back to File, New Design here. And this works because this right here is an Electron-based desktop application. And for those of you who aren't coders, I've actually covered a course on Electron, but basically Electron allows you to build a app using web technologies like JavaScript and port them over to an installable executable that works in a desktop app environment. So it's really cool. So I'd have to assume, while I didn't investigate all of the differences between this desktop view and also the web-based in-browser version, there's probably not very many differences. If there are, they're probably pretty small. All right, so I'm just gonna use this desktop version right here. And to get started, you can specify your canvas size and width by height. They should probably make this a little bit more obvious. I could barely read width right there. Not a big deal. But I'm just gonna use the iPhone X preset right here. So, but real quick, before we begin, make sure you check out my site, Corsetro.com, where you're gonna find a bunch of courses on modern design and development. A lot are free, and the others you can access for the cost of buying me like a six pack each month. That's it. Now also, it probably wouldn't hurt to subscribe here on YouTube, and be sure to make sure the notifications are turned on. All right, let's get back to it. Here we go. Now, first, my first impression, and mind you, I have not used this application a ton, but my first impression that I really like the GUI here. It's well designed. Obviously, they have somebody there who knows how to design well, which is great. So first, just to move around in this canvas area, to scroll up and down, just use your mouse wheel. You can hold Control and while using your scroll wheel, and that will also zoom in and out. Shift will make it so that you can scroll horizontally. Also, space left click will let you pan around. Okay, so there's a few things that you'll be able to get started right away. It's very easy. Here's your shape tools, very simple stuff. You can create, you start creating your header of your app or whatever you want with minimal ease. I mean, everything's very standard, which is a good thing. Your type tool here, we have your different rotation and flips, vertical and horizontal, quick access up there. Over here, we have some shape tools, which is really handy. So if you've ever used Adobe Illustrator, then you'll be familiar with their Pathfinder tools. And this is basically what that is up here. We can clip, we'll do that shortly. You can also split things, bring forward, bring backwards. You can export your graphics, and we'll take a look at that. And then you can also do a play/present. Now, one thing to note, there is no actual prototyping. If you're used to the latest Sketch or Adobe Experience Design or any of the other ones that allow prototyping, this does not allow it. It kind of allows just kind of like a slideshow presentation view between your different screens if you have multiple screens in your design here, which we will. All right, so by the way, I should preface this, or I should say, they do have plans to integrate prototyping and plugins and animation, but there's no concrete date on when that will be available. So if you want to look up that stuff more specifically, just go head on over to discuss. Let me make sure I get this right. It's discuss.gravit.io, and you'll see people have been requesting certain things and they've been good at responding. So they're on the roadmap when it comes to animation and prototyping. It's just not there yet. Without, you know, having said that, everything else is really solid. I like this as a design tool. So let's go ahead and just design a quick, I don't know, I guess you could say kind of like an app layout in a mobile version, just so we can get a little bit of muscle memory and figure out how all of this works. So first over here, we have our layers section. We can see we have it's set up into two different panels. We have our pages. All right, so this would be considered a page in and of itself. And we also have the layers down here, and this is where your different assets go. When it comes to your pages, if you toggle this on, you want to toggle between single and multi-page mode. So by default, it's off, but now it looks much like Adobe XD and where you can select the canvas with a page title. You could change the page title up here. I'm just going to call this menu. And over here, we have all the properties associated with whatever is currently selected. So in this case, we have the canvas that's selected. We have the width, height, the opacity. We can change all this stuff. This color, this applies to the background color. This color picker or selector, as you can see, it's very fully featured. It supports gradients, both linear and radial, even angular, and textures as well. So fully featured. And we have a lot of different options down here. So this is a lot more powerful than even Adobe XD currently and some of the other tools out there. Right here, this is for your opacity. And of course, all the other normal color picker stuff. We're just gonna stick with a white background. Now, the reason I named this menu is because one of the core concepts to understand about Gravit is the notion of master pages. You'll see this right here. We can't select anything because there's only one page, but you'll see how this works, and it basically allows you to define templates if you have elements that are reused throughout your designs. All right, so let's create a menu up here with a little hamburger icon. So we'll go ahead and start with a shape tool, and you can click down, you can access different types of shapes here, and I'm just gonna left click and drag all the way out, and it does have nice snapping features, so that's good. And let's change the color. So you can see the properties panel, based on the fact that now instead of a canvas, we have a shape, it has changed up quite a bit. And you can see there's a lot of options, which is awesome. I'll do a real quick overview, but let's go ahead first and change the fill. You can see we have fills down here in this panel, and we have advanced fill settings. We can create multiple fills, which is pretty awesome. But we just need one. We're going to go almost black. So I'm choosing 1C, 1C, 1C. All right. Okay. So you can add multiple borders. We're not going to do that. I think we're going to do that shortly. But for this one, we're not going to have borders. And there's also effects. You can add blurs, color adjust, drop shadow, inner shadow. There's a lot, so really fully featured, which is a great thing. We're going to zoom up holding control key and our mouse wheel, and we're going to add a hamburger icon menu over here. Now, what's really cool about this is if we go to symbols, libraries, and we search for what we want, like I'm not sure if hamburger was what I searched for before. It must have been menu. You'll see you have a lot of different options here. This is awesome. So simply take it and just drag it over. There you go. So obviously we need to scale this down and change the color here. So if we go to our layers, we'll see that automatically it's a group, and we have a compound path and a path itself. So if you want to change the colors, then we need to double click into this area to select the actual path, the compound path here. So the fill, now we can change the white, and let's get this moved up here appropriately, holding shift to scale down. And I'm just gonna use my keyboard arrow keys. Yeah, something like that's pretty good. All right, great. So now let's create a secondary page. And this right here is basically a template that we're going to use. So what we can do is create a new page here. And we'll click on it and we'll choose master menu. So now it's going to replicate. We can't change anything here. It's just going to replicate whatever is over here. That way, if we have a bunch of pages, like 5 or 6 different subpages, they can all use this this master page. One limitation, though, I found that you can't have nested master pages. They're only going to use whatever's on this one. And if I'm incorrect about that, let me know in the comments. But now we can start working on page 2, which we can just call, double click over here. We'll just call this home. And now let's define kind of like a hero section of sorts. So we'll zoom up here. And we'll go ahead and use the pen tool this time. We'll do something a little bit more trendy instead of a boring, a rectangle. So I'm just going to left click, hold shift, and we'll go right around here, hold shift, and then we'll come down at an angle right around there. Okay. So now let's give this a gradient. So of course, it does accept gradients. So we'll choose a linear gradient, and we're going to click on this very first color picker right here, and we'll see that applies to the left side. And we'll choose, let's see here, maybe just a bluish color. Right around there. All right, and then we'll choose the second color picker up here to the top, and this one, make it more of like this tone right there. All right, and of course we can adjust this around to the exact angle that we want. Right there looks pretty good. Now let's also take this and let's add a drop shadow to it. So under effects, we go to drop shadow, click the plus sign, and now we're gonna have your X, Y, and blur amount. I'm gonna make the blur 0, but we're gonna take the vertical, and we'll go down, I don't know, maybe like 8 pixels. All right, and then we'll change the opacity to go even further down, around 20%. All right, now this does also have a border. I don't want a border, so let's put 0. All right, good. So now let's go ahead and work with the type tool for the first time. We'll just left click once your text here. We'll just say company, hit escape to select it after you're done. And we'll choose a white color. And instead of Open Sans, I'm gonna use the one I've been using for past couple months, Montserrat, for these tutorial demos. All right, and we'll make it bold. All right, so now let's say we want to make an adjustment on this so that this is more in line on a horizontal level. We have to make the adjustment over here. There we go. Yeah, I might move that up. There we go. All right, so continuing on, let's do a text area where we could just drag. So we can left click and drag. And then let's just say we want some lorem ipsum filler text. We just type in lorem space. Very, very handy. So you don't have to go to lipsum.com or whatever. Change the font size. Let's try 13 maybe. We'll select all 13. Okay, there we go. And then of course you have all of your other, your typical options. You have alignment, you have spacing. Just looking down here, scale font on resizing, so that's a nice handy. And I don't want this amount of text. Actually, I just kind of want like right there. All right, hit escape. I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger, like 16. No, 15. Here we go. That looks good. We'll take down the opacity just a tad bit, so just a little, around 72. And then let's do a call to action button. And it's just gonna be a circular one that will say go or something like that. By the way, don't use call to action button text with go. I'm just making it simple though. So let's go ahead and choose an ellipse. Come in here in the center, shift and alt will allow you to scale from the center. And we'll just keep it white with no fill or border, or no border rather. And then inside of it, let's left click and drag from the very left to the very right. I mean, we have guides to help us there. I'm just gonna type in go, hit escape, center it, and then we'll change the color here. And we can use this eyedropper tool just to use something around the same area. And we'll make it bold so we can see it. So Montserrat, bold. I wish it remembered the previous font selection, but yeah, no big deal. And there we go. So we'll just say that's the header. All right. Let's fill this out just with maybe just three different feature areas, just so we can demonstrate more of what's happening with the app. So let's see here. We'll have there's three sections with a subtitle, a little description with lorem text, and we'll replicate that three times. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, this is sort of like a trendy thing recently. We're going to take the rectangle tool, and I'm just going to make a square. And then I'm going to use this corner tool like this, very handy. You can even have advanced settings, which I assume allows you to, you're able to, what does fancy do? Oh, that's cool. So these are really cool. And you can adjust these. That's awesome. And of course, you can export the SVGs with the export tool after this, so they're actually usable. All right, so we're just going to use round. What's round two? Ah, nice. All right, so we'll say like that, and then we're going to rotate it while holding shift. And so now it's been rotated about 45 degrees, and we're just going to put this on the edge. It's one of those trendy things people have been doing. Make it a little bit smaller. Now, we don't want this hanging off, so how do we deal with that? Well, we'll take a rectangle tool, or you could use a pen tool, whatever, it doesn't matter, and then just put it right on the edge, and the guide will help you. It kind of snaps there. Hold both of them with the shift key, so they're both selected, and now we can use these Pathfinder tools, and I'm using some Illustrator terminology. And now we can just do subtract. Ta-da, awesome. So now this is an actual vector thing. I would assume gets exported. Don't quote me on that. I would hope that that's how it behaves. All right, so now inside of here, I guess, I don't know. I mean, you could make this more solid color instead of this gray. I'm gonna leave it at gray, and I'm gonna put an icon in here. All right, so let's go back to the libraries, and I don't know, I'll just type in bike. Okay, so now we got all these cool, well-designed, well, some of them are well-designed. This is a pretty good one. So if I click this, by the way, we don't have to drag it. You just click it and it goes there automatically based on the currently selected artboard. And we'll just scale this in, put them, right here or so. Yeah, okay, there we go. So now we'll get back our type tool. Just to save time, I'll hit Control D to duplicate this. Hell, you know what? I might as well just take both of these. Control D to duplicate them. Now we got to change the colors here. We'll make both black for now. And then we'll drag this in. We'll make this one more of like a gray. Just create some separation visually. This one, we'll just put subtitle here. We don't want it to be the same size as the logo, so we'll take it down just a bit, maybe like to 16. This one, we'll take it down a bit too, to around 13. We'll drag this up just a bit. All right, cool. So now let's say, okay, we want three of these. We don't have enough room. So to go back and adjust that, we'll go to home. We'll take the height. I wish you could just left click and drag up to change these, but you can't. I know you can do that with XD though, but we'll just type it in manually. We'll just put in 1500. So now We have more room. And so now we'll take these and we'll duplicate them. And by the way, you can also create what are called layers. These aren't layers in and of themselves. These right here, if you click new layer, we'll see it says layer zero. There's nothing in it. And you're supposed to be able to select these and just drag them in here. But it's not working for me. I don't know why. I might be doing something wrong, or there might be an issue. I looked at their videos, and it shows them literally dragging it, and it goes into this, but it won't select the damn layer. So if someone can, you know, help me out on if I'm actually doing something wrong or something, I don't know. Let me know. Either way, the layers just give you don't have to use them. It just helps out a little bit in certain contexts, probably like this one. So now I'm just going to take this. We're going to duplicate it, Control D. And now at this point, we can take this one and we can use this rotate, or this flip horizontal tool rather, and hold shift. We'll just drag it over here and then drag our text that's over here. And there we go. This might be worth adjusting so that it's right aligned, maybe. Yeah, that kind of makes sense. That's better. There we go. There. Pretty good looking so far. So again, if you want, okay, well, we can put in, I don't know, like a medical. Okay, so let's just replace this real quick. Just getting more repetition here. All right, so I selected this and it's not going in there. Uh-oh. Well, it's way over there. That's why. It's probably multiple copies now. Nope. We want these to be around the same size, so I'm going to just compare it against this one. All right. And finally, I'm just going to copy this one, duplicate it again. I'm not going to bother with making the icon adjustments. Just want to make sure everybody's, you know, we fill it out a little bit more. Awesome. Okay, so now I find myself saving. All right, I paused and saved it somewhere. Now, again, so it's like just to get a little bit more muscle memory here, let's go to layers here. And we take this and hit Control D, we'll duplicate it. So now we have this home copy. It's not over here. There it is. All right, so let's drag this over here. Okay, now we could see that it lost this header. That's because when we have to select it and we have to choose menu once again. All right, and so now we can create, you know, yet another page, which I will do here. Let's take this. So let's say, for instance, we want to have like a form or something. In this case, we can, if I double click this, we get access to the anchor point. So I can select both of them holding shift. And then let's just like drag it down a bit. Maybe we'll make it go the opposite direction. All right. We'll drag this down a decent amount, maybe around there. And then let's play around with some of these tools, these selection tools up here. So I'm going to take a rectangle tool right up to around here, a little bit of padding or margin away from the go button. And I'm going to take this layer right here. I'm going to duplicate it, Control D. Actually, let me say Control C and then Control V. All right, so now it's placed in the exact same location. We'll select that one and this one, and then we'll choose under these tools, intersection. So now that just selects what was currently over this part. And then so now we can change this fill here. Uh-oh. Yeah, we got to double click it, or at least I thought we did. Change our fill. How strange. It's not working. Come on. All I want to do is just make this one black. So, let's see here. Okay, I think I had to double click it a couple times. I paused there, and now I see the actual fill. We're going to make it a solid right here. There it is, solid black. And we'll take down the opacity. And we'll create a little bit of just visual separation just through contrast there a little bit. And now we can put in a title. Actually, I'll just take this, duplicate it. Control C, Control V instead. And then we'll just drag down using Shift. And this is now underneath. So now we need to take, where is it at? Right here. And we can just drag this up. There we go. Now it's on top. And we'll just put a, like a text area, I don't know, your name, escape. We'll put 13 regular. Let's zoom up here. Okay, so now we'll take a rectangle for the text area, or the text field rather. We'll make this black with a lot of transparency. I don't know, something like that, that'll do. Move it up with the arrow keys. I think that looks fine. So now we'll just duplicate, Control D, and then we'll do it one more time. And now it remembered the spacing, so that's kind of handy. And of course, if you want to yourself, actually these kind of look a little bit far away, you can add a call to action button down here if you wish, maybe in the same, oh, screw it, I'll just do it too. Takes like 2 seconds, being lazy. All right, you probably want to use different, oh, by the way, they're, where are they at? There we go, it's these two. They need drag up top, there we go. Yeah, you would want to use different call to action text, but that's fine. So let's say, for instance, you're happy with this, you want to present it or something, you know, make sure you save it. And now you can click this play slash present button. So we click it and you can use your keyboard arrow keys to go back and forth. So obviously it's less preferable than, you know, it'd be nice to be able to click this and show the page transition animations and go before them. And but there's no prototyping here yet. So that's just something to consider. But it's free, so you can't really complain too much, and it's also on the roadmap. So hopefully you enjoyed the tutorial and you've learned quite a bit. I like it as a design tool. There's some things that are a little bit strange, but really it has a lot going for it. So I'm definitely a fan. Very soon I'm probably going to cover another one, another prototyping design tool, Figma, I believe I might start doing. So I'll see you guys very shortly. All right, goodbye.